Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Prestige, and today I have a pretty unique gameplay for you. This is the Lisle Sniper. Of course, this is the suppressed sniper rifle in Call of Duty World War II. I don't know what it was yesterday, but for some reason, I ended up unlocking three different variants of this weapon, and the first one I got was the Nightfall 2, which is this gameplay right here. This is also my very first time ever using this in a public lobby, so you're gonna see me unlocking the camouflages as I'm using it. And I end up actually getting a V2 rocket in team deathmatch with the sniper rifle. So to me at least, that's pretty impressive. I don't know what was up with this enemy team. I wish I could always have people on the enemy team that played like this, but they were just running into my sniper bullets left and right. There were a couple of close calls. People were sniping back at me. And of course, when you're playing on a map like Gustav Cannon, snipers are going to be your best friend, especially if you take over the cannon and you have control of that with your team. I figured for today's video, we could take a moment to talk about the Lisle Sniper, how it acts in public matches, how it feels online, and of course, this is our very first weapon outside of the pistol and submachine gun category that has a suppressor. It's not coming in the form of an attachment either, so you're not wasting a slot on that. It's integrated, meaning it's built into the sniper itself, and you'll always have that no matter what attachments you have on this weapon. The best part about this conversation we're about to have today is we're looking at it in its purest form, meaning we don't have ballistic calibrations, we're not using a 4x optical. There are no attachments on this weapon whatsoever. But let's go ahead and kick things off, talk a little bit about the damage and what it's capable of doing in game, talk about the handling, how it feels in game for me at least, because if you're on the fence on whether or not you want to unlock the Lisle with armory credits, this is going to be the video for you. So first things first, damage-wise, it's incredible. You can get a one-shot kill from the stomach area, the torso, and up. So I originally thought it was in the chest up, but having that little extra area is great, especially when you get caught in some sort of close quarters engagement. When you don't have a choice whether or not to switch to your weapon, you have to take the opportunity to either quick scope or of course try to no scope. This is going to give you a bigger chance of surviving because that bullet's going to land, and if it hits anywhere in that area, it's a one-shot kill. This is also good because that means if an enemy is already hurt prior by another teammate or maybe got hit by a concussion grenade or something weird like that, that means the one-shot kill area is extended to their entire body. You could shoot them in the pinky toe at that point and get a one-shot kill. Handling-wise, it feels awesome. It feels great. It feels accurate. It's fast. It's a bolt action sniper, so every single time you're done, you're gonna have to pull the bolt back, eject, and then of course feed in another round, but it all happens pretty quickly. I don't think that you're gonna have to use rapid fire by any means with this particular rifle. Getting feeds with quick scopes, it's super easy to do. I was running around with this thing in team deathmatch shipment, and I was able to snipe people no problem with quick scope. So if you're somebody who particularly only quick scopes, it's fast, fluid, and you shouldn't have any issues whatsoever. I would compare this to almost the pre-patched Car 98 when it was super fast and super fluid. It's a little bit slower than that, mind you, but it is easy to use. And of course, it's the best sniper currently because it has a built-in suppressor. You really can't beat that. I mean, the only thing that's better than this is the PTRS, specifically because it gets you a one-shot kill anywhere on the body, but having the Lisle is nice because it keeps you off the radar, so if you miss a quick scope or if you miss a shot, it isn't likely that you're going to be seen right away. Combine this with the basic training of Lookout, and you'll be able to see people from really far distances. Of course, pairing that specific basic training with anything other than a sniper still works, but having the sniper extends that range, for those of you that didn't know. And I know that I recently said that the PTRS is my new favorite sniper in World War II, but I gotta give it to the Lisle. This thing is freaking awesome. I absolutely love how easy it is to use. I love the integrated suppressor, and I guess it comes down to the question, is it worth spending armory credits on getting this thing? I'm confident in saying yes, it definitely is, especially if you're someone who snipes often. This is an extremely valuable tool to have in your weapon cache, especially if you're looking to get those stealthy nukes like you see here. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much gonna conclude everything I wanted to talk about today in this video. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If you did, take a moment of your time to click that like button down below. Do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you guys haven't yet, click click the little bell icon next to the subscribe button, join the notification squad, and let YouTube notify you when my videos go live. I'll catch you all on the next video. Peace.